In today's video, I'm going to show you the step-by-step process I use to analyze deals on behalf of my clients, and we're going to come up with the best targets based on the highest cash flow per month per business. Let's get to it. Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. I am your host, Leo Landaverde, business broker and commercial lender, helping you buy and scale profitable businesses. If you're a small business owner looking to increase your wealth through mergers and acquisitions, or if you are a W-2 corporate executive looking to get out of the rat race by purchasing a profitable business, then you've come to the right place, and I'm gonna encourage you to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit the bell and you'll be notified every Thursday when a new video comes out.
Okay, everybody. So as promised, let's get into it. There's going to be some simple but powerful calculations that are going to help you realize that a lot of the businesses for sale online are way overpriced, particularly if you're trying to get seller financing or trying to get the financed by the SBA. I think you need to understand what the mechanics of what sets the value and how you should approach it. No, there are some knowledge that you need to have as you're looking at these deals to see what the industry standards are versus what the seller is asking for. So with that said, what you see in this blue section is what is given to me by the seller. This is a business that I found online. You know, I'm omitting the location because the location is not really important. It could be anywhere in the US, but I do like these types of businesses. Service delivery businesses that are recession proof, or whether it's inflation or recession, it doesn't really matter. You're still gonna get your plumbing. You're still gonna need plumbing. You're still gonna need electrical services. You're still gonna need fast food. There's a lot of things you're gonna need regardless of how the economy is doing. And this is what I strongly suggest to my clients. They're looking up for their business. Get more into the pain business versus the vitamin business, anything luxury or anything that would be a good idea to have versus something that is critically needed. I will always lean towards something that is critically needed versus something that would be a good idea to have. So with that said, we're analyzing this plumbing business. So here's what I'm being given. The asking price, or it's 1.25. The revenue for this, I assume that this is the last fiscal year revenue, $2,167,000. You can see that right there. And the cash flow is $226,000. And so if immediately as I enter the cash flow, you're going to notice here that the seller is asking for 5.5 times a multiple of seller discretionary earnings, which is what SDE stands for. So now it's only helpful if you already know what the industry standard multiple is for this specific type of business. From my research, I know that this, because it's less than $1 million in SDE or seller discretionary earnings, they usually you can easily negotiate a 2.5 times your SDE multiple. So for instance, a 2.5 times, okay, I know that number. So a 5.5 times is grossly overpriced. Now it may still can easily negotiate a 2.5 times your SDE multiple. So for instance, a 2.5 times, okay, I know that number. So 5.5 times is grossly overpriced. Now it may still be a good deal. We're gonna find out what the numbers tell us. So this information is what is given to me. So I'm gonna get back to the good, the bad, and the ugly, whether I think this is a green light business or a red light, you know, or green, should you just go ahead and make an offer, or yellow, proceed with caution, or red, this is definitely a no-go. So the down payment information comes from what is already being given to me. Sometimes you're not going to get all this information, but this actual business, I liked it because it gave you a lot of this information you can just crunch in your little calculator here. So telling you that the financing available is the 12.5 is buyer down payment. So you would have to come up with $156,250, that the seller will carry a note equal to 12.5 times of the selling price, or you have to kick in equity of 156, which is the how it works, 12.5 and 12.5. And you would have to get a traditional commercial loan, which it's a 75% of the value of the purchase price, or $937,500. This is the information that you're given. Collectively, it's going to be 100%. All right. So let's say you go with what, the, you know, say you don't question the, say you really like this business and you're okay with the valuation of 5.5 times and you have the $156,250 down payment and you want to work with your traditional small community bank or any of the large banks that can actually finance you this deal at 75% loan to value of the deal. So the financing would look like this. If the seller is willing to carry a note, assuming a 6% APR, 5-year repayment term, so 60 months to pay, the annual debt service on this deal will be $36,249, as you can see here. A traditional commercial loan would assume a repayment term of probably no more than 5 years, assuming a 6.5%, perhaps even higher. But let's just go with 6.5% to see what it will do. Now, here it tells me the debt service coverage ratio. For this deal to work out, depending on the bank, you're going to need a minimum of 1.25. If you're going with a traditional lender, it's going to be at least 1.25. So you notice that we have a problem right now with this setup. If you put 12.5% down and the seller carries even a 75% LTV, your debt service coverage ratio, which is the ratio of cash flow to the debt service, is barely breaking even, which means that there is no net income beyond the debt service to grow the business. Now, what's worse is that the annual cash flow after debt. So here, it's a typo here. So we're looking at the annual cash flow after debt, which means that you take your cash flow given to you by the seller, minus the seller carry debt service annual and the annual debt, you know, payments to the bank, your negative cash flow after debt service. So your cash on cash return is negative 19% and your cap rate is 18%. Now, I'm going to start to throw the cap rate as I do this analysis, just because it's good to compare if you're a real estate investor that is struggling to get, you know, anything over deals, finding deals that are anything over 8%.
If this video is resonating with you and this is actionable content, please do me a favor and like and comment on this video. You can ask questions, you can give me direction, or any feedback would be appreciated. So what it does with the algorithm is every time you like and comment, it helps YouTube find other people like yourself who are looking to learn the same way. So thank you so much for doing that.
Having at 18% is not bad. So this is the only redeemable quality about this deal, as it is stated right now. 18% cap rate, but you have negative cash on cash return, and you have a negative annual cash flow debt. Now, there's other variables that could happen. Now we could say that you can negotiate a break, and instead of 1.25. We go with, instead of 5.5, it becomes 5. And, you know, you're still gonna be dealing with probably negative cash flow. So what I like to do right now is this is when knowledge becomes power, because if you know that this industry standard multiple is 2.5 and you already have a 5.5 here, you know that you have some room to negotiate. Now, I'm oversimplifying my offer just because for the length of this video. But there's one thing that is noted in the actual listing, that the furniture and fixtures that are available, including the asking price, that's $340,000. Right now, I'm putting this aside, the furniture and fixtures, as a negotiating point. I am taking the cash flow here. And what I'm doing is I'm superimposing here the cash flow times the industry standard multiple. Now, something would have to be extraordinarily awesome about this business for me to pay 5 times. But why would I pay over what the industry standard multiple is? If this is an average business, even if it's been a business that's been around for 10 years, you need to understand the motivation for the seller to sell the business. Now, what if the seller is selling just because the business has been losing money every year for the last 3 years, and this cash flow is actually from 3 years ago? Remember that a lot of these assumptions are going to have to be tested during due diligence. So what happens is you actually make an offer based on the information that is given, and you may actually be willing, the seller might be willing to share prior to the letter of intent some information about the business, like, you know, financials. You may be able to get 3 years worth of financial statements. You know, it'll probably be in PDF. You won't be able to dig deep. You won't get a lot of information prior to making an offer. But a lot of the discovery takes place during due diligence, at which time you can actually back out and get whatever earnest money you have, because this is your inspection period. But with that said, I'm going to pretend that the cash flow at 226, 331 is real. And I know that the multiple is 2.5 times for a business this size, which is seller discretionary earnings less than $1 million. So instead of 1.2, I would offer 565,000, which is totally defensible based on the valuation for the industry. Let's just pretend to see what happens. I'm just giving you the best case scenario. You might end up offering a little more, but right now I'm going with that. So we're not touching the furniture and fixtures right now. We're just going strictly with a cash flow multiple. So if you were to go the route of the SBA, which I strongly suggest, why not take advantage of the most leverage that you can? We're only 10% down and a 90% LTV loan. See the difference already? Instead of 75% LTV with a commercial, you're actually financing 90% of the purchase with an SBA loan, probably a 7A loan. What I'm calculating here is assuming 7.5 on a 10-year repayment terms. Now, here's the beauty of the SBA. You're going to get longer repayment terms because it's an SBA loan, and the SBA corresponding lender will be guaranteed at least 75% of the loan amount by the SBA. And there's a reason why the default rates are lower with the SBA. It's because the SBA lenders do a good job in really helping you analyze the deal. Because if the deal doesn't make any sense, if it's not going to give you the cash flow, which I'm going to talk right now about, then you don't get a loan on a business that is losing money. So you shouldn't be paying for more, you know, for principal interest payments on a business that is already losing money. You're not going to get the loan, but it's probably the best thing that you don't get the loan. So keep going. So their annual debt service is $102,000. Now, our annual cash flow after debt, which is where I kind of love. So you take your cash flow minus the annual debt service, and it gives us $123,868. Now, the difference here, notice the difference of $153,000, because on the first deal situation, we're negative cash flow. Now we're positive cash flow to the tune of $153,000 difference. And this is a real situation that could happen, obviously driven by the purchase price. Now, here's what's important for you to know. Remember what I said about debt service coverage ratio? It has to be at least 1.25. In this case, it's 2.21. It's a solid deal. It's a solid deal from the number standpoint. Now, let's take a look at the business itself. So if I was analyzing this deal on behalf of a client, I highlighted this section. This plumbing and piping company has a client base made out of 80% repeat customers. How many customers? I don't know. Is it 10? Is it 100? It doesn't tell us. It is actually based in Michigan. That we'll know that much. Comes from 11 employees. 7 of them are field and 2 estimators. Situated in a growing industry and strong location. You know the price. There's plenty of room to expand. So it tells me right now that this is a solid established business that would be a good business for the right person. Now, if you happen to have experience, if you're doing a roll up, if you already own a plumbing business in a different part of the country, you wanted to continue to expand, and you know this business, I'm saying if you make the right offer, you may actually be cash flow positive from day one. People come to me all the time about it, starting a business. It's very difficult to finance a startup because it doesn't have any revenue. So I would always suggest it's better to buy a cash flow asset rather than starting anything. So again, the offer would be 565, but let's say you wanted to pay a little more. You really like, you discover that it has 100 customers that I have steadily paying, renewing they're this work is almost guaranteed. It's almost like an annuity. You're getting this repeat business at, to the tune of 80%. And what we don't see here is the rate of growth, but we would have to find out during the diligence what revenue did we did in 2021 versus what is the 2022 year to date expected to be at the end of the year. What did we do in 2019? What did we do in 2020? What was the outcome? What was the effect of COVID, if any? But so, I mean, so this is things that you need to look at, right? Strong location, 80% repeat customers. Now, let's say you wanted to pay a little more. Maybe you want to pay three times. Look at right now at three times as seller discretionary earnings. You're looking at an offer of 678, still a far cry of the 1.2 million that the seller wants. So there's still a little room for negotiation. Your down payment goes to 67,000 and your financing is 611. We would just have to calculate, you know, your debt service is going to be a little more, which we will calculate. But let's say even if it was a little more, maybe even if it was 135,000. This is for the sake of illustration. I would actually have to do an amortization table, but I'm just illustrating. Even if your debt service went up to 135,000, your debt service coverage ratio is still 1.68, which is still solid. Your annual cash flow post debt still 91,000. And the difference between the two scenarios is pretty good, right? So this is really what it's like to analyze deals. There's a lot more other variables, but the most important one is, can the business that you're buying take on the debt and be able to be fiscally responsible enough to cover the debt by at least 1.25. Hopefully this video was helpful to you guys. And comment and let me know if this is helpful. And I'm going to continue to do videos like this. Thank you so much.
For a limited time, I'm giving away my cash flow calculator, a powerful and simple tool that takes three numbers and help you make sense of it. We're going to take the cash flow of the deal you're analyzing. We're gonna calculate the debt service, that's number two, and we're gonna calculate the cash flow post debt service, which is very important to know how much cash is left after servicing the debt at whatever down payment you're putting on. I think this is a very effective tool and it's yours to keep. All you have to do is click on the link below at the notes section of this video. Thank you.